dear viewers and students, today I am going to deal one of important chapter in sociology, social problems. The Indian society as well as the other societies of the world facing different problems. Particularly in this chapter, I am going to refer some of the important problems like child labor, sexual harassment, female infanticide, hunger and malnutrition, gender discrimination, child marriage, human trafficking, and all these problems and the steps to solve these problems. First, try to know about the problem of child labor. Child labor. In the previous chapters also you have came to know about this child labor. Particularly, child labor, who is child labor? The children who are under the age of 14, those who are below the 14 years of age, and they are working for financial consideration, they are called as a child labor. Below 14 years and working for financial consideration, it is the child labor according to Indian constitution, those who are below 14 years of age and they are working in any particular field, that may be agriculture, industry, hotels, garages, anywhere, and for financial consideration, that is called as a child labor. And here these children who are working in various fields, and they are in many numbers. And if we take into consideration 2011 census of our India, that is according to 2011 census, in India 12.6 million children are working for financial consideration. Child laborers. And throughout the world, the number is also very more. And throughout the world, it is 215 million. That is 215 million worldwide. Throughout the world, and in India, 12.6 million people are the children are adopted for work, and they are working for financial consideration for earning. And it is about the children, child labor. And who is called as child labor? Already you came to know those who are below the 14 years of age, and those who are working for financial consideration or earning purpose, they are called as child labor. Okay, then those who are above 15 years, and if they are they are also working, they are not considered as child labor. Here now with different amendments, now the children who are the above 15 years, they are called as adolescent, and those are also called as adolescent laborers. And there is a law in order to prohibit the the people who are above 15 years and up to 18 years, they are also not allowed to work. They are called as Adolescent Labor Protection Act. Adolescent Labor Prohibition Act was passed, and according to this act, this act was passed in the year 2016 with some of the changes. And according to this act, any child or any person who is above 15 years and up to 18 years also cannot employed in any kind of dangerous job. Any kind of dangerous work they cannot perform, and anyone cannot take any kind of dangerous work from the people who are from 15 to 18 years of age. They are called as adolescents, and these Adolescent Labor Prohibition Act was passed, and according to this act, they also cannot be adapted for or employed for working. Here let us try to know about what are the important provisions of 2016 Adolescent Labour Prohibition Act. According to this, number one, what is the number one means? Those children who are below 14 years. Those children who are below 14 years, they cannot be that is employed in any sector below 14 years. Below 14 years, they cannot be employed in any sector. If anyone is employing them and taking work from them, they will be fined. They will be fined with 50,000 rupees and 2 years imprisonment. Employer of they punished by 50,000 rupees and 2 year punishment. It is the first provision of the Act, Adolescent Labour Prohibition Act of 2016. It is the first provision. And what is the second provision? And according to this Act, any family who they cannot engage their children below the age of 14 years in any there is a household activities and away from the school, that is also considered as a child labor. The parents will be punished. Parents punished for any household or outside activities, and if they are employed for that one, the parents also will be punished by, that is a fine of 10,000 rupees. 10,000 rupees fine will be imposed upon them. 10,000 fine. It is the second provision. And the third provision of the Act is, as per this Act, those children who are above 15 and 18 years, from 15 to 18 years, they cannot be employed in any kind of dangerous work. If such children or the adolescents who are employed in any dangerous work, they will be punished with a 50,000 rupees fine. 50,000 rupees fine will be imposed upon those who employ the adolescent from 15 to 18 years in any kind of dangerous work. This is the three important provisions of the Adolescent Labour Prohibition Act. Okay, this is let us try to know about which are the important work which are considered as dangerous. According to the Act of 1948, that is a 1948 Act, Industries Act of 1948, it identified 29 type of work as dangerous. 29 type of work as dangerous, and later with 2016, another two works were considered as dangerous. Totally 31 works are considered as dangerous. Which are the important examples for that one? Here, any kind of work taken from the adolescent and children's in the chemical industries, or any cement industries, or even that is explosives, and even other various jobs are there, that is mentioned in the Act of 1948, and later in 2016 with amendment, two other jobs were included. Totally 31 jobs are considered as dangerous, and the adolescent and children are not able to perform those jobs. If they perform also, that will be hinder their growth and development. Physical, mental development will be, that is hindered because of these type of job. It is about the various type of works. Okay, let us try to know about the Already we came to know about what is the meaning of child labor and which people are considered as children and what type of work they are not to be performed and what is the provisions in Indian Constitution as well as Act which prohibiting the child labor. Now let us try to know about what are the important reasons for child labor. If the children are going for work, why they are working? What are the reasons for the reasons for child labor? Why the children are going for earning? What is the reason for them to send for work? There are many reasons are there. Among them, the first one is lack of social environment and respect for children. Lack of social environment. Lack of social environment. The children are also considered as a one of a tool for earning. That kind of social environment we are having in our the society, it is also one of the reasons. And the other important reasons like child marriage, those who get very early marriage and they are also go for working and earning purpose with the husband and the children, and even the wife also taken for the work. Child marriage is there, one of the reason. And another the human trafficking. Many children are kidnapped and sold to the people and they also sent for working in different kind of jobs. It is also a reason for the child labor, lack of social environment, child marriage, human trafficking, and even the agricultural crisis. The agricultural crisis like a drought situation or any other kind of situation will be there, famine kind of situation. At that time the families, agricultural families, they shift from one place to another place. They migrate from the rural areas to urban areas in the search of job or for seeking the work. And when they go for the job, they left the schools also, the children also go along with them, and those children will be sent to the different kind of work, and they are also considered as a tool for earning. This is the agricultural crisis also responsible. And other failure to implement the compulsory and universal education policy. Failure to implement free and compulsory education. Most of the children are remaining out of the school, and those children not getting education and up to a particular level, then they will be sent for working. This is a failure of government or other various sectors also responsible for the child labor. These important can be considered as a reason. So lack of social environment, child labor, human trafficking, agricultural crisis, failure to implement free and compulsory education can be considered as the reasons for the child labor. Okay, these child labors are considered as a social problem. Why this is considered as a social problem? What are the demerits of this child labor that we are to know about? Demerits. Why it is considered as a social problem? Demerits of this child labor. First one is, it will affect the physical as well as even the mental development of child. Affect physical and mental development of a child. And the children who are below 14 years or even below 18 years, the adults, they cannot develop any kind of skill. And they will be denied of various rights. Denied of basic rights. basic rights as a child. They have different kind of rights, right to get education, right to that is enjoy their life, having the that is leisure and even sports activities. All these will not be given for the children who are adopted for, who are sent for the work. That's why they are considered as a demerits of child labor. And here, what are the solutions? How this problem can be solved? Solutions for child labor. Here, what is the important solution? The first important solution for the solving the child labor is providing better education. Providing universal education. It is a holistic approach. Providing education to all. Every child should be, that is, in school. Whether they are not sent for work, or that is, even they are in the home also, bring the home activities also, they are also considered as a child labor. And this problem can be solved with providing universal and good education to all, and ensuring gender equality. Second solution is ensuring gender equality. The equality among girls and boys should be considered as equal. It is also one of the solution for this problem. And stopping migration of families. Stopping, earlier I told you that is because of agricultural crisis, famine, drought and other situations, the families are migrating from the villages to urban areas. That is also responsible for child labor. Stopping migration of families. It is also a solution for the child labor. And then creating awareness among, creating awareness on effects of child marriage or child labor and the demerits of those should be aware by the people. We have to create awareness among the people. It is also another thing. And along with the government, other local institutions also take participation in solving this problem. Government and local bodies play a good role in order to solve this problem. This is the various solutions to solve the problem of child labor. Okay, it is about the child labor. Next, we try to know about another problem of our Indian society, as well as it is also a problem which is found in the other parts of the societies of the world. That is the sexual violence against children. Sexual violence against children. Nowadays, these cases are increasing because of the present media, as well as even social media also responsible for sexual violence against children. So it is in order to protect the children from such kind of activities or atrocities, one of the act was passed in 2012, and that is called as Protection of Children from Sexual Offence Act. Protection of children from Sexual Offence Act 2012. It is about the act, and this act is also playing very important role in order to prevent this any kind of sexual violence. What is sexual violence? Sexual violence considered as any unsafe touch. Any unsafe touch, that is called as a sexual violence.